Hi students, in this part solution part 4 we are discussing abnormal molar masses, Wanda factor and some key points related to the Wanda factor and colligative properties. Okay, first we are going related to abnormal molar mass. So why we will get abnormal molar mass? Generally, any colligative property if you are taking, that is directly proportional to the number of particles. It is directly proportional to number of particles, and also colligative property inversely proportional to molecular weight of solute. So these two points are there: colligative property directly proportional to number of particles, and colligative property inversely proportional to the molecular weight of the solute. So when if dissociation is taking place, dissociation takes place, what happens? The number of particles will be increases, number of particles increases. Then what happened to the colligative property? Colligative property increases. Then what happened to the molecular weight? Molecular weight of solute will be decreases. Not decreases means we will get lesser than expected one. If it is a association is going on, same in number of particles will be decreases, colligative property increases, and molecular weight will be comes more than expected. Okay, so what is generally we are calling abnormal molar mass? If molecular weight we are getting is higher or lower than expected value, we are calling as the abnormal molar mass. So in order to avoid that abnormal molar mass, what a factor will be introduced. So Wanda factor, what is the formula we have? Is a normal molecular weight by abnormal molecular weight. Normal molecular weight by abnormal molecular weight. And observed colligative property by expected colligative property. Observed colligative property by expected colligative property. Or number of particles after dissociation or association by number of particles before dissociation or association. So these are the basic expressions for the Wanda factor: normal molecular weight by abnormal molecular weight, observed colligative property by experimental colligative property, number of particles after dissociation or association by number of particles before dissociation or association. Okay. When dissociation is taking place, okay, the expression for alpha, okay, alpha will become this I minus 1 by N minus 1. Okay. If it is association is taking place, association takes place for alpha expression I minus 1 by 1 by N minus 1. Okay. Here alpha is the degree of dissociation, I is a Wanda factor. What is the N? N is the number of particles after dissociation. Number of particles after dissociation. Suppose we are taking NaCl. So after dissociation it gives two particles. So Na plus and Cl minus. So it will be 2, n equal to 2, like. And here, what is the n? N is a number of particles before dissociation. Okay, two particles combining and giving one particle means n value 2. So it is forming the dimer. So dimer means 2, trimer means 3, tetramer means 4, like that will be comes here. Okay, so this is a formulas for a degree of dissociation and Wanda factor related formulas we have. Okay. Now we will in questions, if it is they are not they given alpha value, we can find Wanda factor by using alpha and by using their molecular formula we can find N and I we can able to find. Same way here also we will find, like that. If they are giving dimer, trimer means we know the N value. If they given alpha means we can able to find the Wanda factor. Now, if it is 100% dissociation, alpha is 100%, okay? If it is alpha is 100% will be, dissociation will be takes place. Then, if it is like when I equal to 2 will become, I equal to 2 will become for NaCl, KCl, any complex with the one countryon, okay, will be give the I equal to 2, because 2 ions will be give after dissociation. Okay, suppose example for this one, cobalt complex, you are taking NH3, 4, Cl2, Cl, etc. Okay, when I equal to 3 will becomes, when it will give 3 particles. Okay, 100% dissociation, K2SO4, 2K plus ions, 1SO4, 2 minus ions, or complex like this, CONH3, 5 times Cl and Cl2 oxide. Okay, it gives the 3 ions, 2 counter ions, 1 complex ion. And I equal to 4, I equal to 4 means you have AlCl3 and K3, FeCl6. Okay, this complex like this CNNS3, 6 times and Cl3, etc. This will lead to the water factor 4. And I equal to 5 means like 100% dissociation case, Al2SO4 thrice and K4, FeCn6. In this case, 4 counter ions, 1 complex ion. Like this case, you will get water factor will be 5, you will get it. Okay. So when water factor we have to consider is 1, means like particles, glucose, fructose, urea. In question they mentioned non-electrolyte or non-volatile solid, non-volatile solid without any alpha value. Then you have to consider our I value equal to 1 for that one. Okay. So glucose, fructose, urea, which will be not further dissociate, that ions case we are taking I equal to 1. If it is dissociated, if they are mentioned alpha, by using the alpha values, we can able to find the I value. If alpha is given, then you have to follow the previously discussed formula, alpha for association, alpha is equal to I minus 1 by N minus 1. Or for association, I minus 1 by 1 by N minus 1, we are using. Okay. So that is a way to find the Wanta factor. Okay. Now, how this Wanta factor we are relating with the this one colligative properties. Okay. How we are relating the colligative properties we will discuss. Okay. So first, what is the first colligative properties? Okay. We have relative lowering of vapor pressure P0 minus PS by P0 is equal to I into chi. Okay. So all colligative property directly proportional to I value. Okay. So that's why P0 minus PS by P0 is equal to I into KV. Or I into NB by N total. Or if it is a dilute solutions case, we are writing P0 minus PS by P0 is equal to I into WB by MB into MA by WB. So here we are introduced Wanta factor. Okay. In case of elevation in boiling point, delta T, I into KB into M. And in case of freezing point, delta Tf, I into Kf into M. In case of osmotic pressure, phi is equal to ICR. So like that, all the formulas will be changed based on the by using the Wanta factor. Okay. So most of the times we have to write the formula including Wanta factor to avoid the errors in the answers. Okay. If it is NaCl given, K2SO4 given, CaCl2 given. So what is the I first you have to find, and then you have to find the related answers. So this is the formulas will be have for that one. And finally, we'll go some important key points related to which one? Water factor and colligative properties related. What is the key point? Any colligative property is directly proportional to I into M. First key point. Any go. So elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, or osmotic pressure, relative low vapor pressure, that all properties are directly proportional to I into M. If M is constant, then directly proportional to I. And we have lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, we have relative lowering of vapor pressure. We already discussed directly proportional to I into M. Say the lowering of vapor pressure also directly proportional to I into M. Okay, but vapor pressure inversely proportional to I into M, because here when this I value increasing, the lowering of vapor pressure will be taking place. So vapor pressure is inversely proportional to I into M. And second one, what? Elevation in freezing point. So that is also delta TV is directly proportional to I into M. So if you have I value increases, boiling point will be increases. So that's why boiling point directly proportional to I into M. And same way, we have delta TF is directly proportional to I into M. So depression in freezing point directly proportional to I into M. And freezing point decreases, I value increases, freezing point decreases. So freezing point inversely proportional to I into M. Okay. And last one, osmotic pressure directly proportional to I into M. So these values we have to check it. Other than that, sometimes weight is given. So weight is given, or weight percentage is given, or weight by volume percentage given. In this case, the colligative property directly proportional to weight, or by molecular weight, or weight by weight percentage by molecular weight, or weight by volume percentage by molecular weight. So we have to consider molecular weight in that case. Okay. And if they are asking related to which one, weight percentage we have discussed, they ask the conductivity of complexes or ions case. Conductivity is directly proportional to I into M. Suppose two ions are there, like complex CO, NH3, 6, Cl3 will be have more conductance than CO, NH3, 5, Cl2, and the CO, NH3, 4 times Cl2 and Cl compared to the CO. So like this, number of, here water factor is how much? 4, 3, 2, if it is no ions, counter ions, 1. So it will be conductivity of this complex is directly proportional to I into M will becomes. If same molarity, this is the order will becomes. Okay. So these are some key points related to which one? Solution. So final water factor related and colligative property related. Okay. So time we all discuss which one? Part one we have discussed Henry's law mainly. Part 2 so, liquid solution. Part 3 colligative properties, and part 4 will be discussed water factor related. Okay, thank you for watching.